We're talking LAMON BREWSTER, former heavyweight champ. He beat Vladimir Klitschko before anybody, before it was popular, shocked the world. Then he fought Robert Helenius. Can we see the eye? Can we see the glasses? What happened? What happened in that fight, LAMON? Tell us.
Well, just to start, the morning of the fight, I get a phone call and the phone rang, and someone answered. Well, my wife answered the phone. Obviously, it was just me and her in the room, and someone had called and said, "Tell LAMON to be careful. They're going to try something sneaky." They hung up the phone. All right, who knows what sneaky is? So she didn't want to say anything to me because, you know, what are you going to say to, especially your husband, before a fight? You know, I'm in Germany. You know what I mean? I'm not in my backyard. So anyway, we get to the fight, and as we get there, we walk past a room. I see his room. He got, you know, doors shut, whatnot. Cool. But it was like about, I don't like, almost like 3 hours before the fight, man. Like, why are you, you know, 3 hours before a fight? You know, anyway, I go to what I thought would be my locker room. I was just in the gymnasium with all these other fighters. Like, they had already thrown me to the curb, whatever. So I waited for about, I don't remember honestly, but it was a good time to like have us to go watch them, you know, in terms of wrapping his hands, right? And then them have somebody come watch me wrap my hands.
It's a standard procedure, yep.
Yes. So when I state this to them, they say, "Don't worry about it." Like, what? Don't worry about it. They said, "We're using Austria rules." I ain't never heard of that. They said there's no glove inspection under these Austria rules. But I'm like, but you guys haven't told me this. You know what I mean? I've never, since I was 7 years old, when I started boxing, I've never ever had a fight and not have a glove inspected. You know what I mean? And so then it was like, I was like, well, I'm not gonna fight. Like, that doesn't make sense, you know? And so they came back and was like, "Well, if you don't fight, you're gonna have to get your own way home from this venue." I'm like, "What you mean? What, you mean back to the hotel?" They said, "No, from not only the venue, but to the hotel. From the hotel, which is 2 hours out, 2 hours south of Checkpoint Charlie, you gotta get yourself back to Berlin, and then you gotta get your own way home, along with your wife and your team, and then we're gonna sue you." I'm like, "Huh? Like, is this real? Like I'm, is this real?" So you know what, man? I thought about it, you know? I said, you know what? I always said I'm a man of God regardless. And I said, hell with it. I'll take the fight, you know? So I took the fight. So when I got into the fight with the guy, man, I just noticed, now mind you, his record, he didn't have a good, like, knockout record, you know what I mean? And he was fighting bums, you know what I mean? I noticed, like, he knocked a lot of dudes out, so he ain't that big of a puncher, you know? And so anyway, when I got in the ring with this dude, man, I promised, man, like, his hands, that, listen, man, I've sparred with people like Lennox Lewis and some of the biggest punchers in boxing.
You beat Klitschko, he was a big puncher, yeah?
Yes. There is no way on earth nobody's hands could feel, I mean, I felt like what do you call this, we're standing on a marble? And that's what it felt like, man. So anyway, so in the sixth round, whatever it was he had, it cut my eye. And so they stopped the fight because it, like, I had a lash, the cut went across my cornea and my iris. And Dr. Robert Carnes of Beverly Hills, the fight doctor for the forum for all those years, he said, "These cuts are inconclusive with boxing." I'm like, what are you saying? He said, "In my 40 years, I've never seen these type of cuts, because, like, if you pull your eyelid down and you take, like, an X-Acto knife, and then you just, like, slit the, that's the way it looked, you know?" And so then when I got home, they told me, they said that I did it myself and that I didn't report it. But the fight was stopped because of my eyes. So what do you mean I didn't report it? And then they was like, "Well, you'd have to get a lawyer. You have to fly to Germany, get a German lawyer to fly, I mean, to sue the largest German promotion." Like, really? I just said, okay, man, you know, I said, God does things, and he works in mysterious ways. Sometimes he closes a door to make you go away that you don't want to. So I just perceive it as, you know what, this is God saying, I am putting an end to your career in the ring because I want you to be a champion outside of the ring. So everything that I'm doing now is trying to build a body of world champions under one umbrella without managers and without promoters, so that we can use all of our contacts, all the people around the world that know us, so that together we can eat. Like, why would we not?
Let me ask you this, David. So you lost vision, no vision.
Yeah, no vision.
Any other fighter that fought him had a similar experience?
Samuel Peters.
What did he say, the heavyweight?
He was saying, his story was a little different. And to be honest, I would rather you ask him, because okay, I'm the worst. Don't ever tell me to tell anybody anything.
Okay, have you seen Robert Hellenius since that day?
Yeah, I did, right, man.
And what happened when you meet?
Nothing. So I was at the Hall of Fame in New York.
Yeah, Canastota.
And about 2 or 3 years later, he came, and he was with the promoter. So anyway, he was just like nothing, like everything was just cool. But I'm like, dude, I'm blind for the rest of my life. Like, you can live with that. You know what I mean? Like you want to win that bad that you would be willing to, like, take a man's eye. Like, I'm a father. I have 4 children. I have a wife. I got to live the rest of my life. Like, even when I shake hands, I have to put my hand out first because my depth perception is so off because having one eye. You know what I mean? So, you know, it's just like, anyway, I'm going
okay, deep really quick.
You,
so yeah. Wilder's fighting him. What do you think? What happens in that fight? Deontay Wilder, Robert?
You know what, man? I hope Wilder go out and dominate, man. Not because, I have this personal issue.
You like Deontay?
I like Deontay.
And I like,
man,
Malik Scott, of course, we all do.
What's that?
We like Malik Scott. Works with him.
I like Malik Scott too.
Okay, so let me ask you this.
Yeah.
Your second fight with Fury, there was a lot of suspicion that Fury had something in the gloves because the glove was bending all the way down. It just, the thing he was hitting, he never hit that hard before. Were you aware of all that? Did it bring back, like, wait, could it happen again in the sport?
Well, see, man, so here's the thing. The worst thing I can do is tell you what I believe, because I could be wrong.
Okay, so you don't wanna,
yeah. What I would just say is, all things done in the dark always come out in the light, man. That's why you got balance. You know what I mean? So if he did good, he'll be rewarded good. If he did bad, at some point he'll be rewarded bad. And that's just
okay.
That's just my take.
Layman, two more questions. I'm done. Thank you so much for being so candid and honest.
You
Usyk, if he fights Fury, what do you think?
Okay, so me personally, right?
Yeah.
Looking at it from all different angles, I believe that Fury's going to win. Why? Because I believe that he's just too big. He's too massive. And a guy like Deontay Wilder, with all the power, he couldn't get to him. So I wouldn't think that a guy that's even smaller than Wilder, that's even shorter than Wilder, that don't punch as hard as Wilder, would have a chance no matter how good he is. Now, I could be wrong, but I'm just saying, he have to work so hard to try to get to a guy that if he take one step back, you got to take 10 to get to him.
Okay, Wilder and Joshua.
Wilder, Joshua, you know what, man? I wish you wouldn't ask me that question. Why? Because I have an infinite amount of love and respect for both of those guys, man. And it's like, at this point, because of what they both have been through, man, it's like, I don't want to even see those
dudes
fight. Okay. They got a whole lot of other guys out there to fight.
All right. You know what I mean? Next one is similar to this one. Spencer Crawford.
Is that camera waterproof?
All right. So let's walk around here. What's your favorite memory of Mike Tyson, LAMON BREWSTER? I know you got a lot of them.
My favorite memory of Mike Tyson.
For you personally, yeah.
Yes. Okay. So I had a fight. In Atlantic City.
Yeah.
And so after the fight, unbeknownst to me, Mike Tyson sent a limo to pick me and my wife up, and then he took us to dinner. And so after winning like my 5th or 6th fight, I get to spend time having dinner with my hero. You know what I mean? So that's my greatest fight.
He's the best. He's the best. Mike is the best. You heard what Hulu did to him. Hulu did his life story without his consent, without paying him. Pay the man. Pay him. It's his story.
I don't understand, man. I don't.
It sucks. But hey, LAMON BREWSTER, champion.
Yes, sir.
Hall of Famer. Look out for him. Stay tuned. Maybe everyone can follow you at Lamon Brewster. Stay tuned. Any message for Wilder if he's watching?
Well, my message for Wilder is that I believe in you, brother. I believe in you. Get your game plan and let's go to war. I'm behind you 100.
There you have it. Stay tuned. Now you take back reporting.